afternoon, and welcome to the second episode of Third Gear.
That was my line, wasn't it?
Alright, good afternoon, and welcome to the second episode of Third Gear.
So today we will be doing a public transportation race.
That's right.
And the race is going to be to Philadelphia 30th Street Station. Nick and I are going to be taking the train public transportation, and this guy will be taking the yellow Corvette,
and we will be racing from roughly here, Harrisburg, of course, where we are now, to Philadelphia, over here on the eastern side of Pennsylvania.
I think our train's leaving. I don't know.
Is that our train?
What time is it?
It's 9:22.
Yeah, well,
all right. Our train leaves at 9:30. And it's, once we leave, right here we're at a parking garage right outside the train station, and once we leave, that's when the time will start.
These two are going to have to walk to the station. I, of course, will be driving because they elected to choose public transportation, which was the wrong choice. Therefore, they are not allowed to drive a car.
So when we get to the station, what is it, first one to the top of the steps outside of the train station is the winner.
Ready?
And with that being said,
go!
We are going to beat these two idiots because they have chosen the wrong mode of transportation, that is for sure. Now, I should mention that we do have a tunnel coming up, so therefore. Very nice.
I need to come out. I'm sorry.
We're all out of breath because we're all out of shape.
That's our second thing. We just got a couple minutes off our time.
Second thing. He, of course, hits every green light.
That was me. Red light.
Oh, no.
Now, I believe this is the right car for this challenge for a couple of reasons. Number one, these new Z06s come with 650 horsepower and 650 pound-feet right from the factory. And in case you forget that, there is a small badge to remind you here on the center console.
You don't.
Yeah. Alright, sorry, I'm out of breath.
We need 3 to 30th Philadelphia. What if he doesn't have
a Alright,
he's going. Yeah. Would a driver's license number work? I'd give you that.
Didn't even think about that.
Okay. I'm always nice. So I forgot my wallet, which means I forgot my ID, which means...
which means this nice lady really helped us out. Because we would have lost. There like, goes the race right
like, there. I've never forgotten my wallet, but apparently today I did. So...
Thank you.
All right.
Let's go.
3 minutes.
We are departing the station.
You're in the train and it's leaving already?
The train's moving.
Yes, 9:30 on the dot.
Yep.
The train's leaving early. That's no good.
It's not leaving early. It departs at 9:30.
This is America, and usually public transportation is reliably slow. So it's not good that your train actually left on time.
Where are you at?
I'm on the highway.
Well, now the viewers are going to actually see if Mike finally wins a race.
Shots fired, buddy.
Alright, boys, well, best of luck to you. I'll give you a call in a little bit, or you call me, whatever.
Alright, buddy. See you soon.
Alright, talk to you soon.
Later.
Alright, well, it would appear as though they have already left the train station. It's 9:30 on the dot, and I was hoping that the train would, you know, people dilly-dally, I was hoping that they would be leaving a little bit late. This is not good for me, but oh well, we're going to make up time here once we get on the train. Philadelphia.
Let me just say this, if we wouldn't have ran,
we may have been very close to missing this train.
We probably would have missed the train if we wouldn't have run.
If we wouldn't have ran and I had my ID, we'd have been going quicker.
Yeah. but somebody...
We're not going to mention names who that is.
I should have invested in an easy pass prior to doing this challenge. Oh, this is horrible. See? God damn it. You can't reach the tickets in these cars either. Here we go.
It's an hour, 40-minute trip about. And I think that's about what bikes is.
Well,
no traffic.
The funny thing is, like, trains will usually not be late. You don't have to deal with traffic, but they plan their stops.
I now have my ticket. It is a straight shot on the turnpike pretty much the entire way there.
Well, we decided to move seats. The conductor, is that what you call it? Is that what you call it?
I think
conductor.
So. Yeah.
I don't know. The guy takes your tickets, came up to us, and he was like, you know, you can sit over here. There's a bunch of four seats. It's nice, and there's nobody here. It's great.
We have our own car.
We can be as loud as we want.
We have our own car right now.
Yeah, we literally
like,
do.
Like, we can frolic around, play football, you know, do all sorts of shit.
I want to play that game where we, like, do the bottle thing.
This is not going to go well. Point shown.
Did you watch the new Celebrity Apprentice?
You watch it because you're favorite.
Oh, dude, oh yeah. This is funny as shit.
I don't know what I want for dinner tonight.
I can't even think about dinner right now.
Like, if I want a peanut butter and jelly, like, call it a day.
Well, like we were saying before, it's going to take an hour and 40 minutes to get to our destination. And trains just, they're not really late. It's very seldom they're late. So we're pretty much guaranteed to get there at 11:10 was the time.
Yeah.
So we departed at 9:30. And then Mike, those of you that don't know how bad Philly traffic can be, or just driving in Philly in general.
Getting into Philly.
Getting out of Harrisburg. The drive in between is fine. It's getting close to Philly and getting out of Harrisburg sucks. But then again, it is a Sunday. So it's kind of interesting to see. But then again, it's pretty crappy out. I don't know if you guys noticed when we were leaving, the roads are all wet, so it's not like he can go fast. Like, he's got to pretty much take it easy.
Hopefully I can cruise at about 90 and make up some time and make sure that I win this race.
His destination is pretty close to the same amount of time. No traffic, no questionable things, so.
I picked the car. I can't possibly lose.
We'll see.
You hear them?
If we have to listen to that the entire time, I'll take the loss now.
Why is it doing that?
I really hope you guys can appreciate what the hell is going on right now.
Well, the good thing is when the train gets going, that kind of drowns out.
It stops,
yeah. It stopped.
Well, it's like it's supposed to open when the train stops and slide open.
Oh, so it's like one of those elevator doors that we keep, like, keeping open.
It's the sensor, yeah.
Yeah.
You keep bumping your hand. So we just stopped in Middletown, and that was, like, 3 minutes. So basically we're going a straight line for the most part from central Pennsylvania to Philly. So we pretty much have to hit Lancaster, I would think, is the biggest city in between. So, well, and Reading. I don't think we would hit Reading, but Lancaster's the big one. That's usually a 10 to 15 minute stop. We're pretty confident.
Yeah.
Pretty confident.
Yeah, this is a pretty solid representation of Pennsylvania as a whole. I'm driving in the right lane, and three cars just sitting in the left lane driving. And you wonder why, you know, there's always traffic jams and it takes so long to get someplace. Well, this is your reason.
Oh, salted caramel nut. I don't want this.
Wait, donut?
And I'll tell you what, I ask myself every day why I am friends with those two, and I really can't come up with any good reasons.
Who doesn't want a fucking donut?
About the only other disadvantage that I think I have, or really not a disadvantage, but the only bad thing about today is that it's 42 degrees and I am driving with the Z06 summer performance tires, which, to give you an idea of what that feels like, it's sort of as if someone took off my back wheels and tires and in their place decided that hockey pucks would really work a lot better.
Still can't believe it.
Rude tits.
All All right, so we've got 38 miles to go on this stretch, and then another 40 or so on the next after this. And I just saw a sign for a gas station service plaza here about half a mile away. So I'm gonna stop, get some gas. I'm gonna put in 10 bucks or so, get as much as I can, as fast as I can, and then get back on the road. But I might as well do it now, get it over with. And then I'm gonna give the boys another call to see how they're doing. Let's try to make this quick. We don't want to lose to the train. Here we go, back on the road in a second. Onward!
Lancaster.
Are you idiots regretting your decision yet? Because I am way past Lancaster.
Thanks. No, not yet. We're good.
What are you doing on the train? What is there to do?
Football, napping, you know.
Right.
Are you meeting lots of new friends? I hear lovely people take the train. I mean,
no.
Actually, I did back today.
These are friends.
That way you don't have to stop by the desk. Yeah. Everything's all set.
You hear that, Mike? We got Amtrak on our side. They just hooked us up, so you'll have to wait and find out when we're sitting on lawn chairs. Philadelphia, waiting for your ass to get there.
Yeah, Troy, well, I'll see ya.
So,
30 miles past Lancaster right
so
now.
He's there's no way.
Dude, he had to be driving really, really fast.
So, here we are. See that where it says 9 minutes slower, unfortunately? We are that blue dot. We are taking the train into there. Mike is taking the blue line into Philly.
He might get ahead of us most of the trip, but when we get toward Philly, it's
when he hits King of Prussia around here, that's when the slowness hopefully will happen for him, and he'll be stalled with some traffic. So
yeah,
we'll see.
There is no way I'm gonna let this train beat me. It is the speed train, the Amtrak speed train, but it's not like a bullet train in Europe or something. The fastest that it ever goes is about 80 miles an hour. So those two are in for a big disappointment. You know, the other thing that makes a Corvette so good for a challenge like this is the fact that it's a really comfortable car. When you think of Corvette, the first thing that comes to your mind is probably not comfort and luxury. And it's not a luxury car, and it doesn't ride like an S-Class, but it is really nice. You can set it on touring. Everything's very soft. The steering is, you know, light feedback. Really easy to drive on the highway. You can put your cruise control at 90 like I have it. Well, I wouldn't recommend that because you most likely will get pulled over. There are cops all over the place here today, but luckily they've all been on the other side of the road. Anyway, it's a great car for long trips, going to the track, really whatever you want to do. Corvette can handle it.
Can't tell if he's awake or not because of the sunglasses.
All right, the first exit, we're gonna pay a toll here and then no more tolls. And then we will be in Philadelphia. We are making great time. I'm gonna call them here soon to see where they're at, but I can't imagine, there's no way. I averaged like at least 88 the entire way. There's just no way that train is moving fast enough to get, there's just no way. There's no fucking way I'm gonna lose this.
We'll be arriving at our next station stop of Paoli. Station will be next.
Where's that at?
Please exit where you see a member of the crew. Not all doors will open.
The
Paoli station will be next.
Let's see where we are here. I only wear sunglasses when it's actually needed and sunny. You know, like normal people.
I should have bought the easy pass while I had the chance. There goes the Porsche! The Porsche has an easy pass, that son of a bitch. Hello? Thank you very much. Massive potholes. Back on the road.
So, updated arrival time
is now 10 minutes later because I guess they added a stop. Online it said that we were going to arrive at 11:10. Now it says we're going to arrive at 11:20.
This is going to suck.
Little status report from the Corvette. We have hit some pretty substantial traffic. But it is moving. I mean, it's still, we're doing 60 miles an hour, so it's not like it's too bad, but I just can't do, you know, 85 to 90 like I was the majority of this trip. But anyway, I'm gonna give the boys what might be the final phone call before I actually pretty much get into the city.
Oh, here he is.
Hello?
Hey, buddy, where you at?
Almost Westchester, right?
We're downtown, so that's like...
Yeah. You guys are making pretty good time.
We know where you're at. It's fine. You still got to get into Philadelphia.
Yeah, you've absolutely lost this one, buddy. But let me ask you this: how fast does that train actually go?
I don't know how fast I think this train's going. And it's not too fast.
Does it go 95 for the entire way?
I think the train will do it. I don't know. I don't know. I haven't really looked. I'll have to check. I'll check when we get up to speed.
Well, what are you doing now? What, are you going slow now or what?
We're stopping. Yeah, we're picking people up.
Oh, you have to pick people up?
Well, yeah, that's how a train works, Michael.
When I'm driving a car, I don't have to stop and pick anyone up. I just go where I want to go.
But you also have to deal with Philadelphia.
Well, that's a nice city. So... It's the city of brotherly love or something like that.
No, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the traffic.
Tell them we have a straight shot into Philly.
Yeah, we're going right into Philly. After our last stop, we are boom right into Philly.
Yeah, to be honest with you, when I was plotting this out in my head, I know that's where you're going to make up the time is in the city.
Yep.
Because that's where I'm going to be smart.
Yeah.
This Ford Escape just absolutely decided to jump in front of me and slam on his brakes.
Well, have fun, buddy, because we're going to hopefully make up some time here.
What's your arrival time?
It was supposed to be 11:10. That's just
half hour from now.
Yeah, well, that's pretty close then.
Yeah, so if you're
close, the Philly to park.
Well, parking, and then all we have to do is get off the train and walk up the steps. So
I have to run to the station, and then try to beat you there. So it's actually going to be really close.
It's going to be a lot closer than I think we all think. There's no traffic. Where we'll get him is center city of Philly. Because he's gonna have to park. All we have to do is get off the train and go up the steps.
Where's the finish line is what?
Just the exit to the train station.
30th Street Station.
Yeah.
You know, 30th Street Station's huge, so that's what I'm saying. But if he was driving the speed limit, he would be a lot closer.
To be fair, we are on a train that will still be on time. So Amtrak has nothing to do with this at all. It's just how aggressive somebody's driving in Mexico.
This is an extremely stressful situation, I kid you not. Like, this is absolutely real what we're doing here. And I have to say, our arrival times are very close. I'm now in still heavy traffic, but I'm doing 80 now. But it's gonna be a close one, that's for sure. Also, something interesting to mention is that definitely on this trip, I have gotten the worst gas mileage on any trip I've ever taken in my life. I've burned over a half a tank of fuel already, and I haven't even gone 100 miles. Now, normally, if you drive like a regular person, you can get 330, 340, maybe even 350 to a tank in one of these. Not happening. But that's boring. Who the hell wants to get good gas mileage when you can just go fast?
It's gonna be close, but I'm pretty sure we're still gonna beat him because it's like I said.
When he gets into Philly, that's when hopefully it drops down.
Well, I'm no expert, but I would say that we made it. Now, the question is, where the hell do I park? This is gonna be the tough part of this challenge. Starting out in second gear and slipping. Not the clutch, the tires.
That's why I was like, he should have left when the train left the station. He had that extra 10-minute head start. And if he beats us by 10 minutes or 5 minutes, then we know that he would have lost if we didn't give him a head start.
Now, where is the train station?
Arrived at Philadelphia 35th Street Station.
I don't see the train station. It says I've arrived, but...
I don't know. It's,
There it is. Valet parking at the train station. Okay. This is definitely it. What's this? Okay, I definitely can't go in there. All right. But it looks like I can just kind of pull up here and run in right quick. Doesn't look crowded either. Oh, this looks like the place. Lots of cars. Look at that, short-term parking right here. Up to half an hour, $6, can't beat it. Right here, look at this, right in front of the train station. You cannot beat that. I'm even gonna take the time to back in. All right, here we go. There's no way that I lost this. There's no way, I'm right here, but I'm gonna shut the hell up. I'm gonna run into this train. I gotta go give this man his money. Hello, sir. I'm in a race. Here's $6. Thanks, boss. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Well, I don't see Dumb and Dumber anywhere, so. If I was a betting man, I'd say that I won.
Domino's Pizza.
Hey, where are you?
I forget the name of the stop.
Oh, you're at a stop.
We're leaving right now.
I mean, you're not at the train station yet.
No.
Okay, well, I'm like 3 minutes away, dude.
All right, we'll see you when we get there.
All right, man. Good luck.
Later.
What a moron.
You say?
He's 3 minutes away from the train station.
How the hell is that possible?
He was doing triple digits, I'm sure. I'm actually kind of pissed off. I've turned that part of, like, I don't think we're gonna...
Hey, are you there yet?
No.
I'm pulling into like inner city Philadelphia, dude. I'm so close.
Make sure you're on the 30th. The finish line is the 30th street side.
Okay, and we're just meeting inside of the train station, right?
Or we can just meet you right at the entrance.
Yeah, just meet me inside of the building, I guess.
No, tell them to meet us at the entrance of the Philly, like 30th Street Station.
Just meet us right at the entrance of like 30th Street, like right where if you were coming from 30th Street into the station, just right at the entrance.
So yeah, just meet me inside the building. That makes more sense.
Cool. All right, our next stop's 30th Street Station.
Well, fuck. All I have to do is park, so I think you're gonna lose, bud.
All right. Well, we'll meet you just right inside the gate, right inside the station now.
To be fair, I can't find parking, so I'm gonna have to park at least like 2 blocks away.
Yeah, that's what we're counting.
All right, well, I'll see you soon.
All right, later.
Later.
So Mike is coming into the city right now.
Yeah.
He's like 2 minutes away from the station, but he has to find parking.
I thought he was 3 minutes away, 10 minutes ago.
I enjoy messing with him.
So he has to find parking, probably like at least 2-3 blocks away.
Yeah, I don't know how to, I don't think I've ever parked at that station.
And there's no way. Do you think he'll run on camera? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he'll run. And we're gonna meet us right inside the entrance there from 30th Street. So we have to get off, go up the escalator.
That's it.
And that's it.
Or is he meeting us inside the big station?
Yeah.
Waiting for about 10 minutes. Realistically, not that long, but.
So we'll have to, hopefully he can't find parking. Or he drives by a parking garage that's like closer and he misses it. He like parks like a couple blocks away and then he gets his car towed.
Good.
We should
never know what can happen, honestly.
So, I don't, There's still a chance. There's still a chance.
I clearly won the challenge.
So you're saying there's a chance.
Alrighty, so we are only a couple minutes away. We just talked to the
conductor
guy. So, actually arrived closer than we thought, but he's not sure where to go.
Hunan Express.
Hunan Express?
Yeah.
You want the puffer rice?
Where are you exactly?
We're pulling into the station.
Okay, well, I parked and I'm walking in, so you're gonna lose.
Well, you know, they ain't over till the fat lady sings, so.
You better sprint when that train stops. You better jump out while it's still moving. Are you going to?
I'm gonna jump off right now. Except the windows are sealed. See you in a couple.
Alright, later.
Later. He parked.
He parked.
He's walking to the station now. It's close. He's getting ready to like walk up to the station. I'm hoping he like is like saying that when he's like closing his car door.
Yeah, that's how he works. Yeah, he's like, I'm getting ready to leave right now, man, and he's like
30 minutes later
putting his shirt on. Yeah, like what?
Getting ready to leave means you're like starting your car.
He's like, yeah, dude, I'll be in there in like 10 minutes. And then it's like a half hour later, he's just at my house. Like, oh, all right.
Mike is not the most on-time prompt person. Go figure today.
Yeah.
He's on time and prompt.
Ladies and gentlemen, just a few moments. We will be arriving around next station stop, Philadelphia's 3rd Street Station.
Just a few moments.
Okay, so I just spoke to the people at the ticket desk, and I was informed that they will be coming up this escalator right here.
You know what, we should go right by that door.
We're gonna get a head start here and go right by the door.
Okay, location D.
Yeah.
Yep. Just a couple cars up. Woo! Get a little faster for you.
So I'm gonna try to film them without them seeing me. What's great is that literally they're so excited and they think that they won. Look at them go.
He is not here.
He's not here.
They literally think that they beat me.
Yeah, this is it right here.
Best part of the whole day.
Oh, there he is. Look.
Damn it.
So who was here first?
Probably the guy who filmed you coming up the escalator.
They come up the escalator.
The steps.
That wasn't us. Forget this. So
what happened?
Somebody forgot his ID.
You forgot your ID? Well, I should have known you guys could screw up something.
Okay, let's not say you guys. Okay. So second.
Right,
thing,
Troy's organized. Troy and I went to Atlanta successfully.
Yes, and we made it back in like ridiculous time. Yeah.
When I made that first phone call to you, the last thing that I made, the first one was me sitting on the bench. He did get a head start.
Yeah, he did get a 10 minute head start.
Well,
winners pay.
What we learned today is the most important.
We learned that public transport still sucks, and we all still love the car.
Public transportation will never be as fast or as good as the good old fashioned automobile, unless there's traffic.
Damn it!
Well, I win. Those two lost. And on that bombshell, good night.